your audio sound recorder on my computer because there's parts in the Audacity that I want to use audio for. And this has to do with editing. So first I come and I open up the audio bit that I want to put on the mixer. And I just go to File and Import and then select the audio that I want, and it'll ask me to make a copy of the files before editing, and then in parentheses it says safer. Then it says read the files directly from the original, which is faster. And then it gives you the option of don't warn again and always use my choice above, which I never click on that. I always like it when things pop up and I get to make a choice. So I picked make a copy of it. And here you see that it shows elapsed time and remain timing. It's supposed to be less than a minute. Now I have an option of stopping or canceling while it's doing it. Now, this came out as an MP3, so what I had to do is go into my Wondershare and convert it over to a WAV. Now, here you'll see the red line that I have right there. And in my effects, what I do first is, you have a leveler here, which is good. But before you use the leveler, you should go in and edit everything that you need to edit first. And that was from the suggestions from the tutorial. So I go in and I already have my settings up here. And before I hit OK to reduce the noise, I say get noise profile. And now it's creating my noise profile. And it'll take 30 seconds according to the remaining time. I do that first, and then after this is done, I go back into effects, and I do reduce noise again, and I hit OK, and it does the noise reduction. That's not going to get rid of the red line there. And I go into noise reduction and I hit OK. Now I can hit preview, and this is what it does. And it gives you a preview. It's a 6-second preview. And then I hit OK. Now it's reducing the noise. It says that it's going to take 4 minutes. This is off of my sound recorder because I wanted to add it in to the video. And after that, I'm going to start using the noise reduction in the leveler audio bit that you're seeing right here. I'll give you a little taste of the difference in recording there. I don't know what it does. It's just like right now, I'm doing this without headphones, so I'm hearing an echo on the speaker, and I don't hear the difference while I have the headphones off, or until I watch the video. I'm going to go ahead and put the headphones on. Okay, I've got the headphones on now, so hopefully that doesn't put an echo on the audio bits that just before this. I got 1 second, and I gotta wait. Okay, it's on. It's done now. So I go back in. I hit lovely. Now, this said negative 70 dB in moderate the first time, so I like the sound of it. I'm gonna hit. That's the preview. 6 seconds. I liked it the first time, so I did the same thing. I just hit, okay. And it, now it's applying the leveler. And it's only going to take a minute. As you can see, the red line's gone, and I can go from there to my now I am setting up my editing. Hold on, let me plug in this speaker. It might cost me a cut. Okay, so I just plugged in my headphones to the speaker, so I apologize for that if there's echo at the beginning of this. So now I'm doing a quick update on everything that I have done. Right there you saw the Audacity on my resolution. I had my resolution changed to 854x480/480p at 16:9. I had it earlier at 640x360-360p at 16:9, and it was causing issues with the screen where you couldn't see anything that was written whenever it was on there. At the moment, I've also got my Google Hangouts set up, and how I did that was I have two Google accounts, and I set both the iPad up and the computer up with Google Hangouts. And what I did there was is I called one account with the other one through Google Hangouts, and on here it gives you the option of screen share. Now right now I'm sharing screen, so that what I'm seeing with or on the computer, I'm also seeing on the iPad, and vice versa. Now, if I go and I click on mine, it'll do this. It'll just show the picture right there with little, like pulsing things from my voice. If I go to click on here, it'll take me to, on the computer, it'll do this right here. So what I do is I just go over here to my iPad, and I click on Roger for the iPad, and it shows that. Now, when I go to the iPad, I can switch it on to my other screen, and that can be my background. If you notice down here, it has everything that's up here. I'm wanting to be able to put, you know, live video of me on there, but I haven't quite. I guess I'm not smart enough at the moment to figure that one out. But I can switch it around like that. And it's okay. I'm fine with it. It's not that big of a deal. Now, if I turn around and I hit my other one, it leaves it like that. Okay. Also, on my XSplit, there's something else that I wanted to mention, and I don't know if it does it regularly or not, but I'm going to have to start checking in on the open audio settings down here by the mic and the speaker, because on my general settings, I've been having some serious issues here, and one of the issues that I've been having is the, let me make sure you guys are getting this actually, well you should be, but on my general settings in my audio, I have it set to my speakers being on Realtek high definition audio, and it's like that right now, but next time I go in, I'm pretty sure that it's automatically going to reset back to default, which when you do the system sound, you have none default speakers. For me, I have speakers USB audio codec, and then I have my speakers Realtek high definition audio. My computer is set up to only go through speakers Realtek high definition audio and not through the USB audio codec or default speakers, which would automatically be XSplit, and that causes the echo. So I had to come in here and I had to switch it over to speakers Realtek high definition, and I'm pretty sure that I'd already done it.